Hello, I'm Rebecca Roy, and I manage the Park Interpreter Program for Vermont State Parks. And here I am today at beautiful Quechee State Park in Quechee, Vermont. And together, we're going to explore looking at the history that we can tell from the landscape around us and how the landscape has changed over time. And as you can see behind us, we have the oldest steel arch bridge in existence, which this year it's 110 years old. So follow us as we explore the secrets of the past here in Quechee. And as we're hiking along and spending our time together, keep in mind that we're walking on Western Abenaki ancestral lands. And the Western Abenaki have lived here in Vermont for thousands and thousands of years, and they continue to live here today. And they call this place Kitsisakagon. And let's keep that in mind as we're walking together today. Has the landscape of Vermont always looked like this? No, it hasn't. The landscape has changed a lot, and the Ottauquechee River, where we are here, has moved over the years, and all of our rivers move. Have you ever experienced this where your favorite swimming hole one summer is just perfect, nice and deep, you can jump in, and the next summer the sand or rocks have shifted, and so it's filling in or moving downstream? Our rivers are moving all the time. And here in Vermont, we're blessed with having a lot of rivers. We have a lot of north-south valleys with our rivers flowing from the north to the south. And the Ottauquechee River, which we have here, is one of those rivers. And the gorge, Quechee Gorge, was formed here by the river moving over time. Sometimes we have really kind of violent, traumatic events that move our rivers. If you're familiar with the tropical storm Irene that caused a lot of flooding in Vermont in 2011, changed a lot of our rivers, moved a lot of our rivers, and moved a lot of sediment along the way. Sometimes it's really dramatic like Irene, sometimes it's more gentle. Our rivers are always kind of moving on the landscape or trying to move on the landscape. So the story of what happened here is that 100,000 years ago, the earth started to cool and giant glaciers covered this entire area. Giant glaciers covered all of northern New England. As you can imagine, this was a huge, huge glacier or ice sheet that covered this whole area. And it extended out to George's Bank in the ocean. And because the ice of the glacier was taking up a lot of water, George's Bank was actually an island for a while, which is remarkable. So as you can imagine, this ice sheet covering this area had a large impact. And the ice here in Quechee, at Quechee State Park, was over a mile thick. Can you imagine? Over a mile thick. So a mile is, if you're driving along the interstate and you see the sign for the exit that you're going to take, usually that's a mile or two before the exit. That's how thick the ice was here. And today we're hiking along this trail network at Quechee State Park, and this network is about a mile and a half. So the distance that we're hiking is how deep the ice was, which is absolutely remarkable. So let's take a look at what the glacier did to the landscape here. So the glacier covering this area had a huge impact on the landscape. And to demonstrate that, I brought a mini glacier that I made at home to show you how the glaciers pushed the debris on our landscape. So as I push this mini glacier along, notice how it is pushing up and forward all of this debris. So the leaves, the sticks, the hemlock needles are all being pushed by the glacier and clearing the path behind it. That over a mile thick glacier that covered this area pushed a lot more than just leaves and sticks and small rocks, but the entire landscape. It pushed trees and giant rocks and even the tops of our mountains. And as the glacier moved along, it scraped everything off the landscape here. And as it receded, the glaciers melted from the edges and melted back up north. They dropped all the debris that they had gathered. As you can see, my glacier here has a lot of debris on the bottom of it. And as you can imagine, the bigger glacier, that mile thick glacier, collected a lot of debris that was stuck inside the ice. Have you ever made a snowman with that first sticky snowfall of the year? You're rolling up the snowballs in your yard, and because the snow is in direct contact with the ground, you're picking up all kinds of dead grass and leaves and sticks and things into your snowballs. You're making your snowman. Well, the glacier is the same way. It picked up all kinds of things from the surface. And one of the clues that we know that glaciers were in this area is the presence of what's called glacial erratics. And what those are large rocks that are in the woods all around, but do not match any of the native rocks that are in the area. So they were brought here by a glacier by being broken off from another area and then dropped off as the glacier melted.
13,000 years ago, the earth started to warm up and the glaciers started to recede. And at that time, the glacier had a lot of debris in it. A lot of debris fell and made a dam. That dam made a huge lake, which is called Glacial Lake Hitchcock. That lake was 200 miles long. So it went from Rocky Hill, Connecticut, all the way to St. Johnsbury, Vermont. So as things warmed, things melted and melted, water was pushing against that dam. And eventually the Rockingham Dam failed and fell apart. And as you can imagine, it was a violent water event. The bottom of Lake Hitchcock was covered in muck, thick, thick, thick mud. Have you ever waded into a pond and had your feet squish into mud at the bottom? That's what Glacial Lake Hitchcock was, but it was thicker. It was really thick mud. It was all stuff that had fallen off the glacier. And so, as the Connecticut River was flowing, as the Ottauquechee River was flowing, they were eroding away this mud and changed the way the river flowed. So the dam broke and then a huge waterfall formed. But then in this area, instead of just wearing away that mud, it started to wear away that rock. And the reason that happened here is that the bedrock is schist, the metamorphic rock. It has what's called schistosity, which means weak points the way the rock is formed, sort of like the grain that you see on wood. And if you've ever split wood before, you know that splitting with the grain is much easier than splitting against the grain. And because the water from the Ottauquechee River is flowing with the grain of schist, it's breaking away the rock using that schistosity until today we have this 165-foot deep gorge here in beautiful Quechee State Park. And I invite you to come here to take a look at this gorge and visit and hike along and look at how the landscape has changed. I also invite you to look around your home and other places where you like to recreate. Look at the changes in the landscape and the evidence that you see today that tell the story of how that landscape has changed over the past.